BGK. Got me with BGK. They don't really know my name, but they say I look in my face. I ain't got time for these niggas, they just need to take a break. Every day I'm on the knee, praying for a better day. BGK, BGK, they just stop screaming my name. When they really just be hating, cause I'm on my way to fame. Lord, please, this is not a joke. They know that I am a king, but I think they forgot their roles. I said I got big dreams, stepping on big scenes.
Y'all, that song was from PGK, Pretty Girl King, My Girl Asia, and like, yeah, y'all need to get on that. It's on Spotify, iTunes, it's on to get on it. Y'all can really like hear me out right now, because like, this girl making big moves, and y'all gotta get on it, because these songs fire, like, these EPs is fire. Like, y'all need to really get on it, because it's, y'all, I know y'all heard it in the beginning, it's like, it's too fire, you just can't, it's too fire. Support the culture, okay? But yeah, y'all need to go ahead and support the culture, support the movement, whatever. So yeah. Hey y'all, and happy New Year. I've been gone for a while because I've been trying to get like different topics in my head to give to you all and start the new year off right. So it is February. The second day of February. So, yeah. So, today, I'm going to be doing a video about what to expect at a PAHS. So, a PAHS is a performing arts high school. I know some of you all go to it, some of you all don't, some of y'all go to regular school. But, I go to performing arts high school. Like I told y'all earlier in the videos, it's in one of my videos, I go to a performing arts high school. So, let's get on to the video. So the first thing, many people just like, they just think that it's like High School Musical. Like, see, you're not going to be like, we're all in this together once we know where we are and that stuff. No. You want to have somebody like Mr. Leggings and he going to come in here and write you up and put you on his ass. We can't even be on the tables. This is before my arts high school. We can't be on the tables. You got music majors here. You got band majors here. And we can't be on the tables? That's dumb. Next. So, apparently, there's more work in a from arts high school than a regular high school. Because you have your arts and, like, they give you extra work, too. So, you have your four core classes plus health or PE. And then your three arts. So, yeah, it's more work and like you just gotta stay focused the whole time. Like you're not gonna have no time to do anything. But anyway, the next thing is you're going to be busy. Like I'm busy 25/8. Like I don't ever have no time for my friends. Like even though my friends go to the performing arts high school, I do other stuff outside of the school. So it puts me back in the situation where I don't have any time to hang out with them or even my other side of the family. So yeah. I mean I try to hang out with them, it's just that every time they try to plan something, I always have something to do that weekend. No. Or I always go somewhere. It's like that. Okay, the next thing is you're going to get less sleep. I get less sleep for some reason. I do not know why. I get less sleep because I go to sleep at like 12 o'clock. But some nights it be because I have a lot of homework to do or I have to study this song all night because she's going to test us on it. And like, yeah, it just be like that sometimes. And also for the theater majors at our school, the first semester they didn't get no sleep because they had to do all these play cards and all this other stuff. It was just too much for them. And like, these were freshmen, and I'm like, these kids not getting enough sleep because of what you're giving them. You need to pace on what you're giving them so they can get enough sleep, like the 8 hours or 9 hours that they need. The next thing is you need to study a lot. When I mean study a lot for your classes, because sometimes them arts can get really carried away and you end up not studying for a test that you forget about because of your arts. So make sure you study a lot and make sure you have time management, because that's one thing you're going to need when you're in a performing arts high school. You're going to need time management because like you can't forget the things that you actually need versus the things that you don't really need to have. Take your major serious. Like, some people be like, are you going to take your major serious, or like, are you going to do this in a real lifetime? And you say no, or you're going to be like, I'm not going to use this when I get older. that's basically you not taking your major serious. It's basically you wanting to be at the school just because you want to be at the school because it's a performing arts high school. Like me, I take my major serious because when I get older, I actually want to sing, but not like be like a famous singer. I want to be a pediatric surgeon, so I don't want to be a famous singer. I want to still be able to sing. The reason why I'm going to performing arts high school is because I didn't want to stop singing. I didn't want to go to a regular school and just stop singing. And right there, when I'm at performing arts high school, I'm always singing. Make sure you get your work done in your core classes because them teachers do not care about your arts. They say you are not here for your arts. You are here to get your other education before you get your arts education. So, like, if you miss a test because you have to do a recruitment show, and you come back, they're not going to care. They're going to be like, you should have got your work done. It is what it is. So make sure you get your work done and ask the teacher before you go to that show, do I have anything that I need to do? So your teacher won't come backstab you in your back and be like, no, you're not going to get this. And you get a zero in the grade book, which is dumb. But for some reason, I don't understand. But some teachers do. Some people don't. To experience other cultures, like, it's not just a predominantly black school, a predominantly white school, a predominantly Latino school. It's a school for everyone. So I see all types of races and cultures all in the school at once. It's fun. It's unique. There's different sexualities, different ethnicities, like Latino, black, white, or Caucasian, like that. So yeah. All right, that's it for the video. Please comment down what you want to see next. Make sure y'all like and subscribe this video. Tell your friends to subscribe to the video. Tell your friends' friends to subscribe to this video.
Are you done?
Tell your friends' friends subscribe to the video.
Are you done?
And then tell your friends' friends' auntie to subscribe to this video.
Are you done? Are you done? Okay.
And then on from there. You know what I mean? Like, get this channel up. Like, y'all, I go at 175. I'm like at 163. So, y'all go ahead and subscribe. Click that subscribe button or whatever. And, yeah, I'll see y'all next time.